Today we are going to get the rain effect with this tool using only Snapseed app. Watch the full video for some handy tips and tricks. We need to create this, which will be used later as a double exposure image for the rain effect. I tried different methods but finally got better results with the Noir tool. We need to start with the black image though. So on top of this image, I'm gonna use curves and drag the top right point of the RGB curve down, which turns the image completely black. Next, for the Noir tool. It doesn't matter which preset you select here. The options are here. The one main thing here is the grain. First, I'm gonna set the others to 0. Now increasing the grain value to 100 and applying it. Now we need to make the grains as white as possible. Using curves, we'll try applying a high contrast which gives us these white dots. You can also tune it for lesser dots if necessary. Now we're gonna stretch them using the perspective tool. Here, choosing the scale option and dragging from top to bottom on the image, which basically stretches the dots. I'm gonna repeat the same step again and again till I get some small lines. I'm gonna use perspective tool again with scale option, this time compressing it by dragging the image from right to left to make the lines more narrower. With smart filling option, this also fills up empty spaces on either sides. Also adding little blur with the lens blur tool. Just a hint of blur here. Saving this image. I'm gonna revert the image to the original state. Here, to get that overcast look, first, I'm gonna tune with tune image. Here, reducing contrast. Saturation. Also removing warmth by making the image more cooler. Also reducing overall brightness. Now using selective filters, removing the orangish tones by reducing the saturation on these spots. I'm gonna darken the image more with curves. In the masking screen, applying it with 100% on the sky. And with 50% in the foreground. Now, using double exposure, adding the earlier saved image of the short lines and choosing add mode. Reducing the opacity to make it less intense. Also, manually rotating to make it rain at an angle. We'll add the same image once more. This time with default mode and reducing its size to make the falling raindrops thinner for a more natural look. Masking work for a smoother effect. We'll repeat the step once more by adding the image on the right. Masking work to fine-tune it further. The final result here. Hope you found some useful tips here and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.